Hello students, this is Jayapai speaking on the topic solar energy in general and photovoltaic cell construction working advantages of photovoltaic cell in particular. Okay, now in the last class we were discussing about the fuel cells that is working and construction of methanol oxygen fuel cell and also solid oxide fuel cell. Moving on from there, it is all about solar energy here. We are all aware of the fact that we are heading towards an energy crisis. Every day we observe more and more vehicles plying on the roads. For all these vehicles, we have to supply fuels either in the form of petrol or diesel. That means we are heavily dependent on fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are non-renewable energy sources. You all know that. And as the sources of fossil fuels are very, very limited in our nature and they are depleted. They are being depleted very, very fast. So, search for alternative sources of energy has gained tremendous importance. The whole world is now turning towards natural resources, that is, such as solar energy, wind energy, bioenergy, ocean energy, geothermal energy, etc. Among all these renewable sources of energy, it has been found that solar energy the best. It has the greatest potential because solar energy is inexhaustible and it is abundantly available in nature. How much ever you use, it is still there in a large quantity. And we should have only the tool or device to harness this tremendous amount of energy available in the nature. In the last few decades, a lot of effort has gone in converting and utilizing solar energy. And let us see what is that device which converts solar energy into different form of energy, especially that is electrical energy. That is nothing but a photovoltaic cell. Photovoltaic cell or a PV cell, and it is also called a solar cell. Photovoltaic cell is nothing but a semiconductor device. It is a diode, we can say. It is a semiconductor device which converts light energy from the sun into direct current electricity. So it converts light energy from the sun into direct current electricity. So photovoltaic cell or PV cell, it is a semiconductor device which has the ability to convert light energy from the sun into direct current electricity. So we have got a device here which has the potential to harness the enormous amount of energy available in our nature. Now let us see what is the principle of working of a photovoltaic cell. The principle behind the functioning of photovoltaic cell is nothing but photoelectric effect. That is the ejection of electrons from the metal surface when photons of solar radiation strike the surface. By striking the photons of the solar radiation on the metal surface, if you can make electrons eject from the metal surface and those ejected electrons are made to move in a single direction in the external circuit, then we can produce electricity. So that is the principle behind a photovoltaic cell. So photovoltaic cell works on the principle that is ejection of electrons from the metal surface by striking with the photons of solar radiation, which subsequently move in an external circuit and produce electrical energy. Now let us see the construction of a PV cell. And in this, PV cell is made up of two types of semiconductor. One is N-type silicon, another one is P-type silicon. Now, in our lower classes, we have studied that there are two types of semiconductors, intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic semiconductors are pure semiconductors, their conductivity is low. And extrinsic semiconductors are, impure semiconductors. They are found to have high conductivity values. Now, there are two types of extrinsic semiconductors, that is N-type and P-type. N-type semiconductors are obtained by doping pentavalent impurities such as phosphorus to the pure semiconductor. And P-type semiconductors are obtained by doping, that is trivalent impurities into the pure semiconductor. Now, these are the concepts you might have studied in your basic electronics course. In the chemistry class, let us concentrate only on N-type and P-type. And one more point you have to understand, in N-type semiconductors, majority charge carriers are electrons, and in P-type semiconductors, majority charge carriers are holes. Now, when the N-type semiconductor and P-type semiconductor are brought in contact, then a PN junction is formed. When N-type and P-type are brought in contact, a PN junction is formed. And this N-type semiconductor, it is an ultra-thin layer that is kept over the P-type semiconductor. The bottom layer is P-type, the upper one is N-type. And this N-type is in contact with the metallic grids, and these are blocks, metallic blocks or metallic grids. And P-type is in contact with the metallic layer, that is at the bottom. These metallic grids act as one of the terminals of the cell, and metallic layer acts as another terminal of the cell. When these two are connected by means of a metallic wire with an external load in series, that completes the external circuit. And N-type semiconductor, just above that, a thin layer of anti-reflective coating is placed. That is because semiconductor silicon, it has high refractive index. Whatever light falls on the semiconductor, that reflects from the surface. If the light is getting reflected like this, we cannot convert solar energy into light energy. We have to make sure that solar energy, that is light energy, gets completely transmitted into the bulk of the material. It should not, get reflected. Now, this is the construction of a PV cell. Now, let us see exactly how it is. It consists of an ultra-thin layer of phosphorus-doped silicon, that is N-type, on top of boron-doped silicon, that is P-type. So, P-type is placed below and N-type is placed just above P-type. Hence, a PN junction is formed, that is nothing but a diode. Metallic grid forms one of the electrical contacts of the diode. Metallic grid is one of the electrical contacts of the diode, and it allows the light to fall on the semiconductor between the grid lines. So between the grid line, sunlight gets into the bulk of the material. An anti-reflective layer is placed between the grid lines that actually is found to increase the amount of light transmitted into the semiconductor. So it increases the amount of light transmitted to the semiconductor, or it ensures that more light is transmitted into the semiconductor and less light is reflected. The cell's other electrical contact, it is formed by a metallic layer on the back of the solar cell. So this is another electrical contact, that is metallic layer, that is at the back of the solar cell. And this one metallic grid, it is another contact of the cell. There are two contacts, one is metallic grid, another one is metallic layer. Moving on, this is one more diagram of a photovoltaic cell. Here you have n-type semiconductor where majority charge carriers are electrons. This is blue colored circle represents electrons. And this pink colored circles represent holes, that is p-type semiconductor. This is a junction where n-type and p-type semiconductors meet, and that region is called a depletion region. These are the metallic contacts that act as one of the terminals of the cell, and another one is that is metallic layer. This grids and this metallic layer, they are connected via external load. And photons, solar radiation, it is made to pass through the bulk of the material between the grid lines. Moving on. Now, how exactly depletion region is formed? When p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor are brought in contact, you know that in n-type semiconductor, electrons are the majority charge carriers. This rectangular black colored represent electrons, and these represent holes. In p-type, you have holes as the majority charge carriers. When the two are brought in contact, what is observed is diffusion of electrons takes place from n-type to p-type. When electrons diffuse from n-type to p-type, these electrons will go and occupy some of the holes in the p-region. And this is the layer formed where holes are occupied by, electrons which have migrated from n-type to p-type. When electron moves from n-type to p-type, one vacancy is created. The vacancy that is created by the exit of an electron, that is nothing but hole. So on the inside, we have a layer of holes. So because of the formation of electrons and these holes, that is at the junction, a depletion region is formed. It has an electrical field, or you can say it has a potential. A potential is generated. Because of the development of potential here, this system now acts as an insulator. And because of this potential here, further diffusion of electrons are not possible. And in the case of silicon, the depletion region potential is found to be about 1.7 volt. And when sunlight falls on this depletion region, and what happens is the lattice atoms, that is silicon atoms, absorb the photon from the sun, which has the energy greater than that is depletion potential. Energy of the photon is greater than the depletion potential. And because of the absorption of the high energy photons, the lattice sites, that is silicon, it generates electron hole pairs. One new pair of electrons and holes is generated. Likewise, large number of electron hole pairs are generated in the depletion region. And these electrons cannot move towards the p side because already you have a layer of electrons here. So these electrons are drifted towards the n type, and the holes cannot move towards the n type end because already you have a layer of holes here, and these holes are drifted towards the p-type. Because electrons are drifted towards the n side and holes are drifted towards the p side, and these electrons are from the n side, they are made to move in the external circuit. So all the electrons which are moving towards the n end and all the holes are moving towards the p end, and these electrons and then they are made to move in the external circuit in the single direction. So electrons will come here in the external circuit like this, and when the electrons move through this metallic wire, here if you keep a bulb that glows, and we say that solar energy is successfully converted into electrical energy. Now working, when light radiation falls on the PN junction diode, electron hole pairs are generated by the absorption of the radiation. So electron hole pairs are generated by the absorption of the radiation by the lattice atoms. The lattice atoms are silicon, and silicon actually generates electron hole pairs. The electrons are drifted towards the n-type end. Now these electrons can be drifted towards the n-type end because they have high energy, because they are formed by the absorption of high energy photons, and they are collected at the n-type end. Holes are drifted towards the p-type and they are collected at the p-type end. When these two ends are electrically connected through a metallic wire, there is a flow of electrons in the external circuit. Then we say that a photoelectric current is produced and it is available for use. Now this is the photoelectric current, what I meant, that is electrons moving in the external circuit, and when electrons move here in the external circuit in this direction, because in the opposite direction holes are coming and recombination takes place. This is how photovoltaic cell works, and this is the principle and working of a photovoltaic cell. Hope I have made you understand the entire concept. And now after listening to my video, that is again, then you will understand it better. So try your level best to understand the concept. In case my lecture you have not followed, or still you have some doubts, means anytime you can call your teacher and you can get your doubts clarified. Thank you.